So here in our editor, we will now see some additional module resolution configuration options. We will also trace the location where the compiler searches for modules. In our editor, let us make some changes in the tsconfig.json file. We will start by adding a module resolution strategy config option. We already have common JS module here, so the default resolution strategy is node. But however, I'll mention it explicitly here. Now we will see how non-relative references are resolved. Let us go to the player.ts file and change its reference to use a non-relative one. I'll remove this dot slash from here, and this immediately gives me an error. It says it cannot find module person. As we saw in the slides, there are a lot of different locations TypeScript searches for modules based on the configuration of our app and how we reference our modules. It is tricky to understand why a module isn't being found. So to resolve this, we have a TypeScript compiler option called traceResolution. Let us turn this on in our config file. So in the tsconfig file, I'll add traceResolution compiler option here. Now our compiler will output information about how each module import is being resolved. I'll open the terminal. In the app directory, I'll explicitly stop the compiler and start it again. Here is the tracing report. I know this looks a lot to go through and understand, but it is not as complex as it looks. I'll go to the top of the report here and first see the modules that are resolved. You might not be able to see all the reports in your terminal. To do the setting, you can go to Code, Preference, Setting, and here search for Scrollback. Then go to the Terminal option and here change the maximum amount of line to 10,000. So once you do this, you'll be able to see all the reports in your terminal. Here, the first line says that it is trying to resolve a relative reference to the game module from inside the main.ts file. Here, it shows me the module resolution that I had chosen, which is Node.js. And then the next line indicates the location our compiler has searched for the module. This last line for the import shows that the file was found and it will be used as the resolution result. So this was the module which was resolved. Scrolling down a little, let us find the attempt to import my non-relative person reference inside the player.ts file. And here is the resolution for my person module. It says resolving module person from player.ts file. And then it checks the node modules folder and looks for this file with any valid TypeScript extension. When it is not found in the node modules, it moves one directory up and looks for the JavaScript file where it can find any type of my TypeScript files. So here is the search for the JavaScript files, and ultimately it says that the module named person was not resolved. Generally, the non-relative references are used for the third-party libraries, so it makes sense for TypeScript to search for it in the node modules folder. Now, if I move this person.ts file to the node modules folder, let's say I move it here. When I hover over this person module, it says the module was found in the node modules directory. I'll move the file back to its original place. Now let's see some more compiler configuration options to configure more about the location of the module. Let me first create a new module folder inside the app folder. And now when I move this person to modules folder, it again says that the person module was not found. Let's see few more compiler options here. So in the tsconfig.json file, I'll add a baseURL configuration option and set its value to the new modules folder which I have created. This option specifies the base directory which the compiler should use when attempting to resolve a non-relative module import. So now, all the non-relative imports will now happen to be relative to this base URL. We can see the base URL option here, and it is set to the modules folder. In the trace information for the non-relative reference, we can see it is resolving the person modules in the player.ts file. The error here is gone, and here the module was found inside the modules directory. Scrolling down a little, it says person.ts file exists in this location and will be used as the resolution result. So the base URL compiler option is handy if we want to configure a different location for the compiler to search for modules. However, I don't want to use them in my demo app. So I'll just leave it commented out here for you to reference it. Now coming back to person.ts file, I'll move it to its original location and remove this modules directory. I'll also change the reference to the module here in the player.ts file, and it is now using the relative reference. So this was all about the module resolution strategy. The last step to get this going is to configure the webpack as the module bundler so that our app will be out and running again. Let us do that now.